How much money would you need for a sugar daddy to sponsor you so you don't work?
Per month, like maybe 5,000.
5,000, and you could be sponsored sugar baby for a sugar daddy?
Not sponsored, but I would be like fine, you know, to pay my stuff and pay my, bills, pay my rent, yeah.
Would you be okay being the only earner of the household?
No.
You don't want daddy to stay home?
No, no. He gotta work too.
Projectile vomited, like violently. Oof, like it was just bad. And then I was just really, really high for 3 hours. Like, you know that peak when you're peaking?
Yeah, but did it feel good even after you puked?
No, it didn't feel good at all. Like, because after you puked, that's when the molly actually kicks in. And that's when you get very inequivocally high.
Oh, wow.
But for 3 hours, you know, so you're peaking for 3 hours. I'm just climbing up this high and I'm climbing and I'm climbing and I'm climbing. And there's no going down. I'm just getting higher and higher. And Coke fixes everything, by the way. If you're like ODing on molly, Coke cancels out the effects of mollies.
Yo, what's up, guys? We gonna have to try to keep it quiet. We're at the library. Okay, so don't make any noise while you're watching this. If you're eating chips, try to be discreet. Okay, let's see if these girls are down. Girls, do you want to do an interview?
Like on what?
You.
On life, relationships, and dating. 5 minutes.
Oh, I have like zero experience.
You know, listen. You've lived a long life. You're a student now. You've gained a lot of wisdom. And it's time for you to share that to the world. You don't know? You're too nervous? You know, why study when you could just blow up on TikTok and YouTube? Think about it. Life could be way easier than this.
Are you not in school?
No, I graduated.
Oh, so wait, what? Like, you're back here just for, like, these interviews?
Yeah, I'm trying to interview Concordia students. Because I did McGill students. And Concordia students are way more interesting.
Okay.
So you don't want to open up about your feelings? No? No? Okay, it's okay.
Sorry.
Good luck in school, though.
Thank you.
Excuse me. Would you like to do an interview?
Uh-huh.
Would you like to do an interview?
Sorry, I'm late.
No, you're late for something? Alright, what's up, guys? We're here at the best university in Montreal, Concordia University. We're excited to get going. You know, we interviewed the second best university in all of Montreal, McGill, last week. We're about to go in and see what Concordia students think. I'm expecting a lot of sharp cookies coming at me today. So I made sure I got myself a Red Bull because I was feeling a little tired. We're gonna try to make this as entertaining and as insightful as possible. What's something about your last relationship that you learned from that you're gonna change in your next relationship?
Never go out with criminals.
You dated a guy who did time or what?
Well, he's actually in jail right now.
are you still like holding it down for him?
No, well, no, not really.
You let him go after he went inside?
No, not because of that. Because it's toxic, not because he went inside.
Okay. So if it was healthy and you loved him, you would have held it down for him?
Yeah, for sure.
For how many years could you wait for a man? Or months or weeks? Or days?
No, like a few months, not years.
Okay. Even if you love him?
Well, if someone loves me and I love him, why would he like do something to go in jail for years, you know? It's like he made the choice to lose me, so.
If a guy from like out of town, like let's say Miami or United Arab Emirates reaches out to you and is like, yo, I found you, you're mad cute, I want to fly you in, all expenses included in the package deal. Would you be open to that idea?
I don't know. That seems a little sketchy, not gonna lie. Like, why do they want me to come that bad? But if everything's paid and like they're cute, I'd consider it.
You'd consider it. Yeah, okay, yeah. Okay. Has it ever happened to you?
No. It
has it ever happened to some of your friends or girls you know?
No, it has not.
Oh. He's like, yo, you know what? All expenses on me?
No.
No.
I don't want to die. Imagine if he kidnaps me and put me in like woman trafficking and stuff like that. I'm not doing.
But what if you look at his Instagram and his Instagram is popping?
Okay, I can tell him like if you send me $10,000, I would come. But if not,
$10,000,
like guarantee. And if when I go, he's not acting weird, I'm gonna like give the money back. But if he's acting weird, I'll take the money back and leave him.
Ooh, okay. So you already have a game plan.
Yeah.
Do you have?
Be smart.
do you have friends that were offered that deal by foreign guys to have them come over to their country? Have you heard of your friends doing that, or people you know?
Yeah, but.
How does the deal usually work? Is it just like, I'll pay for your flight and everything?
Yeah, it's like, oh, come, I'll pay for your flight and I'm gonna buy you gifts and stuff like that. But you never know, you know, what's the person's intention. So
can you tell us about your wild summer?
So there was a lot of partying involved, and partying means a lot of drugs involved, and a lot of drugs involved means either nights you remember or you wish you would not remember. And basically, like, I finalized my summer with like a little OD, and I was like, okay, I'm...
Oh, really? OD of what?
Molly.
Molly?
Yeah, when you do too much, it's not fun anymore.
Would you ever date a female who was born biologically a male?
Yeah, why not? If I get to talk to her and... I have to talk to her, right? You have to connect. You have to, you know, when you getting into a relationship, it's not roses and, you know, it's not that. So it's you have to talk and get into it. I don't know. That's how it works for me, at least.
Even if she have a PP, is okay, as long as she has a good personality.
Yeah, that is what it matters. I mean, we live in Canada.
We accept everything.
Yeah, it's okay. We accept everything, every culture. You connect. If it's a connect. If it's not a connect, it's not a connect. It's life.
There we go. That's beautiful. You probably weigh like 100 pounds?
I'm 50 kilos, which is 110.
Okay, yeah, that's not a lot. And you probably took a lot of mollies. It was two?
Two.
Two in one shot? And yeah. It was like...
And it was crystals.
Crystals?
It wasn't even like mashed or anything.
Oh, no way.
Stupid. I don't know. Turns out, don't do that to yourself, because your stomach, it's much harder for your stomach to digest the crystal, and it makes the throwing up and the nausea much, much worse.
Okay, so is that what happened?
Oh yeah, I basically like projectile vomited, like violently. Oof, it was just bad. And then I was just really, really high for 3 hours. Like, you know that peak when you're peaking?
Yeah, but did it feel good even after you puked?
No, it didn't feel good at all. Like, because after you puked, that's when the molly actually kicks in, and that's when get very inequivocally high.
Oh, wow.
But for 3 hours, you know, so you're peaking for 3 hours. I'm just climbing up this high, and I'm climbing, and I'm climbing, and I'm climbing. Oh. And there's no going down. I'm just getting higher and higher. And Coke fixes everything, by the way. If you're like ODing on Molly, Coke cancels out the effects of Molly.
So I grew up in a very strict household. There are a lot of rules.
Did that make you want to rebel more?
Sometimes, but I never did.
You never did?
No, never did.
Do you feel like your time in Montreal is when the rebel inside of you is going to come out?
Probably. Yeah.
The hookup culture is very gross, I think, in my opinion right now. It used to be like, oh, like Tinder and Bumble. But really, like, what the fuck are we doing? Well, what's the hookup culture for? Like, you're just having sex with someone and then what?
Yeah.
You're exchanging energies. You're letting somebody enter your room. You're letting somebody, like, you know. And I don't know, like, it's a thing now that, like, in a friend group, everyone just fucks each other. It's like a thing now. And it's like, you're just casually friends with people who see you naked and have been inside you and have, like, spat on your sexual organs, and you know what I mean? It's very intimate, and now it's just becoming a whatever. It's very hypersexual right now. Like, yeah, so I think our attitude towards love should change. Just because love or a certain relationship you have with someone fails doesn't mean it's all gone. And you know, sometimes it's not supposed to work out. You grow from that experience. It's called growth and learning. You don't just shut yourself down and just say, you know what, I'm gonna become a slut or a fuckboy and just no love. I'm just a sex machine.
I think that's what happens with like both parties, where like you get hurt once and then you become like, you're like, fuck everything. Should heal instead of like thinking that you're gonna heal from casual sex.
Casual sex does not heal you. It actually makes the problem worse and bigger. You're trying to fill a void with something that you can't fill things with. Right? You do sex to what? Distract yourself and to empty your system out? And you're emptying your system into what exactly?
Okay, yeah.
Nothing. You're just disappearing, like it's fake affection, fake intimacy, and you're not really getting the emotional support that you actually need from someone.
Have you ever been bi-curious?
Yeah, I have been. I've explored with girls, and it didn't do enough for me. Or like, I guess I can't catch feelings for a girl. I could fuck a girl, but I can't catch feelings for her.
Okay.
It doesn't work like that for me.
Okay, do you think you're over your girl-on-girl phase, or was it just a phase, or is it something that you're down to explore maybe in the future?
It's not a phase, but I don't want to do it again because it's unfair. But if I'm messing around with a girl who is actually bi-curious and she grows some sort of attachment towards me that I don't feel the same sentiment, like, to me, I just fucked her and I was like, nice, oh, you know, but to her, it might have been, oh, this is somebody I actually wanted to stay around, and she didn't because she's straight and she was having fun.
Okay, yeah, you were leading her on.
Pretty much.
Okay, cool. But I love you more and more. What's something about yourself that you recently realized that you're kind of embarrassed that you didn't realize sooner?
I'm toxic.
Like, that you're toxic?
I'm toxic.
Like, still now, or have you healed, or you're in the process of healing?
I'm trying to not be toxic and try to remove those toxic thoughts and negative aura around me. But yeah, when someone or like a close friend comes and tells you, hey, you're actually like toxic and you attract toxic things into your life because you are toxic, that's when it hits you and you're like, oh, that's why the things happen to me, because I attract those things.
Okay, cool. Do you feel like you've realized where that stems from? It's probably a childhood thing that happened that makes you run towards that again.
Personally, my toxicity, it stems from just being a woman and the experiences I've had as a woman, especially as a Middle Eastern Arab woman, Muslim woman also, like that just adds more onto like the what the fuck. So so I'm used to like your traditional macho Arab man who like controls the situation and like says it as it is and blah blah blah. So when I don't find these qualities in a man, I don't feel like I'm around someone who's familiar. Because that's the kind of environment I was surrounded with my whole life, and that's like the macho man for me, like that's the image of a man for me. And it's not supposed to be that way, because that's just like toxic masculinity being digged into my brain like for years. So like the toxic thing for me, like about me, is that if I'm someone with a man who's nice and like really...
You don't like that shit?
I don't like that. Like, I'm like, oh, he's so submissive and so indirect. I don't like that. I like a man who's like direct and all that. But then I realize like, oh shit, I'm into a toxic type. And I don't like, and then I get with the toxic type and I'm like, fuck, who the fuck does this man think he is trying to address me that way?
Like, a lot of people are going through this shit.
Oh yeah.
Like, all the kids are going through drug problems, relationship problems. So it's like, if we put it out there to be like, yo, this is normal. No, it's not something that's unique to you.
Yeah, what you're feeling is very normal, and what you're experiencing is also normal. But just because it's normal also doesn't mean you should, I don't know, follow the same footsteps as everyone around you. Like, just because your friends made a Tinder account and started fucking around doesn't mean you should.
Yeah.
Like that, because that's also another thing, like...
And they brag about it too. They're like, oh, yo, I fucked.
Like, but it's not even like being a slut. You can't even say, oh, I'm being a slut. Like, it's just like, yeah, I'm just seeing people. That's okay. If that's what you want to do, go ahead. But the point is that if that's not who you are, don't fall into the pressure and the voids of like... Oh, I don't sleep around. Am I like prude?
Am I
introverted? Am I like, am I unwanted even? Like,
yeah, and then you try to prove to yourself that you're wanted.
That you're desirable.
Yeah, and then you do it too.
It's just an undying cycle.
Yeah, it's a sticky situation. If you had one piece of advice to give to a younger version of yourself, what would it be?
Don't be so like enclosed in your own mind. Like, just have fun. Sam Ash.
Afshinpour.
Afshinpour.
Yeah. Afshinpour? No, it's AF. So it's Af.
Afshinpour.
Afshinpour.
Yeah. Afshinpour.
Oh, yeah, wait, you gotta hold this.
Okay.
Yeah, okay, well, we'll do a couple things.
Okay. That was the best interview of my life. Subscribe to Sam Afshinpour.